Some people said it's because Governor Yahya Bello did not go through the rigor of election. He does not know what it takes. He just got this particular thing positioned on the silver platter.
Says who?
But he didn't contest.
I am part and parcel of Governor Yahya Bello's campaign platform then. He went around the whole 21 local government.
Just for primary election?
But before, of course, before the primary election, then after the primary election, of course, the person that got the ticket has to do the other aspect of it. But during the election, he was there doing his bit. So if somebody should tell you that he didn't go through the rigors and all that, it's just because he has done it. Myself, now, before my primary election, I want to tell you that the job I've done before my primary election is harder than the job I did after the primary election, before the general election. Because that's where the bulk of the job is. But once you've gotten the ticket, the headache, the onus, everything will not be on the party. It's not party's headache.
And they say primary elections
in Nigeria. Before the primary election, you are doing his job. And everybody knows him. Who? Governor Yahya Bello's name is a household name in Kogi State before the primary election.
What was he known for?
For his campaign. He took the campaign to everybody's doorstep.
So you are judging him as a grassroots politician?
He is, 100%. He is. He's a grassroots politician and he has demonstrated it even in this general election. He delivered Kogi State to APC. Is he not the leader of APC in Kogi State?
Yes, he is.
Is it the Abuja politician that comes to Kogi to deliver it for him? Delivered it to APC.
So, though, I see another question. So, what you are saying now is because he delivered the state to President Muhammadu Buhari,
to APC, we can now assume.
And he also delivered
you. And he delivered me.
So, we can say you are a Yahya Bello apologetic?
Not only that, I'm a realist. I am telling, whatever I'll tell you here today, whatever you ask, anyone that is his own, I'll tell you. Because he's a human being, no man is infallible. He's a human being. So he can make one or two mistakes, but that doesn't mean that it will invalidate all the good he has done.
So since you already mentioned one or two mistakes, what are the few mistakes or weaknesses you've seen in Governor Yahya Bello? Since he's not infallible.
It might be a weakness to some people because he's a dogged fighter. He goes for what he wants, he goes for what he believes in, and that is what many people believe is
so people agree.
And him, you know, when he came about, his administration started new direction agenda. Because he knows that you can't be doing things the same way and we'll be expecting different results.
They said that was the most foolish person's idea to repeat the same thing and expect a different result.
Because he deviated from what the so-called other politicians, because he deviated from that and he has a new direction, way of
what is this direction?
The new direction is doing different things, doing different things differently from the normal norms. And of course, you know, the normal norms is when you bring the allocation, bring it to the table. Let the politician,
give the populace 10%.
So he said, no, this money is for the people.
As if he's telling people not to share the money, but he's just taking his own quota. Because many people, they've mentioned the house he built at Kogi, that he even went there to lunch. They also mentioned his house here also in Abuja. And they said the house in Kogi is worth billions of naira. In a state where people are judged to be very impoverished.
Those that are saying that doesn't know Yahya Bello before he became governor. If you know him before he became governor, you know that he's even more, himself is more impoverished than as a governor than what he was before becoming the governor.
So what I was a stupendously wealthy.
Let me tell you, yes. He is not a poor man before he became the governor. So for people, it's unfortunate that once you are already in the helm of political affairs and all that, people would see you as if you don't have a life before you become what you are now. So if that is the case, let me tell you that Yahya Bello is who he is before he became the governor of Kogi State. And whatever he has more than that. It's what he has gotten before he became the governor. But you see, when
so you have not mentioned the weaknesses.
I've told you the only weakness which I know what you see as a weakness.
Yes.
Many people, some people will see it
as a strength.
What the weakness that I see there is that he is doing things different from the normal norm. And that is what brings his name to the national.
And what he's doing differently is that he's not sharing the allocation within a microcosm population of the Kogaiti, right? Kogi people.
That is just it.